Hi there, my name is Ivanka, and welcome to Scrap and Coffee. In today's Scrappy Basic videos, we'll be talking about chipboard. Now, I want to remind you that how I'm showing it, I'm not trying to tell you that this is the way of doing it, this is the best way of doing it, it's just my way of doing things. So if you find another way that's easier for you or better for you, feel free to do it in another way. So we'll be starting with cutting the chipboard. So I have here a piece of medium weight chipboard. That's what I usually use for my projects. Sometimes I will choose for a heavyweight chipboard. Like when I make a big album and I know it's going to be heavy, then I want it to be a little bit more sturdy. But most of the times I will choose a medium weight chipboard. And when I want to cut it, the first thing I will do is use my paper trimmer. This is a Fiskars paper trimmer. And I always make sure that when I'm cutting my chipboard, I have an older blade in there, because your blades will be going bad pretty fast if you are cutting chipboard. So just save your older blades that you don't want to use for your paper anymore, for your cardstock, and use them for your chipboard. So I have a piece here, and we will be cutting it to size. And in this way it's 7 inches now, and I'm going to cut it at 5, so we get a piece that's 7 by 5. And I just place it in my trimmer, and I will always cut upwards. And I just make sure it's straight, hold it in place, and with a little pressure, go through the chipboard once. Now, what I see a lot of people do, and what I always did in the beginning, was I made my first cut, then I would turn it around, place it again at 5, and make a cut again. But for some reason, I'm always cutting in just a slightly different place, so I don't do it anymore, because I want to have a nice straight edge. So I just make one cut, I remove my paper trimmer, and then I will use a utility knife to cut all the way through the chipboard. So I made my first cut here. Then I will just take the utility knife. I don't need a ruler now, because I'm already guided by that cut that I made with my paper trimmer. And just with some gentle strokes, not too much pressure, you will need a little bit pressure, just cut through the chipboard, and that's my first piece. So I will be cutting the rest of the pieces now, and then I will show you how I wrap my chipboard with cardstock. So I've cut all three of my pieces for an album cover. I've got the front cover, the back cover, and the spine. And we will be wrapping this with cardstock. Now, I have two pieces of cardstock here. And you can use a 65 pound, 80 pound. If you want, you can use 100 pound. It will all work. This is an 80 pound cardstock. And my pieces won't fit on one piece. So we have to combine these two pieces together. So we will be starting with that. And to do so, I will make a pencil mark on the shorter end. This piece of cardstock was 12 by 12 piece, but I've cut it down to 9. So the height is 9 by 12. And I did that because my chipboard piece is 7. And I want to have an inch on the top and the bottom. So that's why I've cut it down to 9. And on that 9 inside, I will make a pencil mark at 1/2 inch. That's just a little guideline for me. And then I will place some double-sided tape between the cut edge and that pencil mark. Then we will be removing the tape backing and get our other piece of cardstock. It's also 9 by 12. And we'll be lining it up. Now I will use that pencil mark to make it straight. And just stick it down. Now I will see if, when I place my pieces, and that's why I haven't cut it down to size in width, where my overlapping of the cardstock will end up when I place it about an eighth of an one inch away from the left side. And it's a little, you want to have some space in between your chipboard, and that will actually be fine, because what you don't want is your overlapping to be really close to your end of the chipboard pieces, or really close to your spine. You want it to be at least an inch of away from your space between your chipboard pieces. So this will be fine. So my next step is to mark a line 1 inch away from this left side. And that will be my start point for where I will be placing the chipboard when we are ready to do so. My pencil lying over there. And I will be, oh, that's not straight at all. Let's try that again. You want it to be straight because you want to have your one inch on the top and the bottom of the piece as well. So on the bottom, I will also make a pencil mark at 1 inch. And if you are feeling confident and you don't need the pencil mark, then you don't put it there. But I really need it to be straight. So then when we are going to place our chipboard, and I can use this pencil mark as my guideline to place it 1 inch from the left side and one inch from the bottom, just like that. And then I will be, when I've placed my chipboard down, I will be cutting my cardstock down 1 inch away from the right side of the chipboard. So the next step is to make sure that it will stick onto the cardstock. So we will be covering these pieces with double-sided tape. And I like to make sure that my whole piece of chipboard is covered with tape. So this is the biggest roll I have of double-sided tape, and it's 2-inch roll. So I will just place it straight as I can, close to the edges I'm possibly able to do. And I just use my utility knife to cut it away. And then I will do the same thing on this side. Cut it away again. And then I'm going to use my 3/8 of an inch tape. And I want my edges to be completely covered, so I will go like this first. And then I will fill it in. And then if I have a little bit of room between those two pieces, then that's fine with me. So I will do this to all three pieces of chipboard, and then I will be back with you. So I've covered all three of my pieces with tape, and I know it's a lot of tape, but you really want it to stick to your cardstock. We spend a lot of time and a lot of money on our albums, so we want it to last. So now I'm going to make sure that the tape is sticking to this chipboard before we are removing our tape backing. And then we will be starting with one of the bigger pieces. So let's get our cardstock back in. And I will be removing all the tape backing from this piece. Might have been a better way of doing this, but doesn't matter. Okay, so now my pencil marks will come in handy. I'm not using any wet glue on this at this stage. Now we'll just line it up with the pencil marker that I've made and stick the first piece down. And then using a bit of a firmer bone folder, burnish this down so it gets a really good stick. Now before I'm going to place my spine piece, I'm going to place a piece of tape here that's going to be helpful for the determining how much space I'm going to leave between my chipboard pieces, but it will also help later on when I place my binding and everything. You have a sticky part here and it will help sticking down and holding on to your binding. So that's why I like to use a piece of tape for this to determine the spacing. But you can also make a pencil mark and then you just draw a line at a quarter of an inch. That's what I suggest you do. So place your ruler and you just draw another pencil mark and then you will place your spine against that pencil mark. And then you also have a nice perfect spacing. But I like to use tape for this. And this is a tape that I buy at Walmart. And it says it's a 1/8 of an inch tape. But it's actually a little larger than 1/8 of an inch. It's closer to 3/16. It's almost a quarter. You can see it's really close to my pencil mark. But sometimes I find that the quarter inch is... spacing is just a little bit too much for my liking, so I like to use this tape for it. And it doesn't matter if you go over that pencil mark a little bit. I'll burnish that down. And then we can place our spine piece lining up with the tape and our pencil mark on the bottom of the cardstock. So I'll remove the tape backing from the spine piece. And again, without sticking it down immediately, just line it up. And again, burnish it down. And then we'll repeat the step with the tape again for determining the space between our chipboard pieces. And burnish that down. And then we will place the final piece. So I wrote down the measurements on the chipboard so you can see what measurements that I have been using for this. Again, I line it up with the bottom pencil mark and the tape to get it as straight as I can on there and burnish it down again. So my next step will be to cut my cardstock down so that I have 1 inch from this right side of the chipboard. And then I will get my big paper cutter in here. And let's see what's the best way of doing this. I want to have 1 inch, so I will line up the chipboard with the 1 inch mark as best as I can. You cannot see what I'm doing. I have to put it in there a little bit offset, not straight, because otherwise it's not going to fit. But I will just cut that piece away, save it for something else. And then this is what I have left. So now I'm going to place double-sided tape on the perimeter of my cardstock and on my chipboard. But before I place it on my chipboard, I have to remove the tape backing from these two pieces. So let's start with that before I forget about it. Because yes, that happens to me quite a lot. I didn't burnish that down pretty good. So. Now for my on my chipboard, I will use a 1/4 inch tape. And what I like to do is, without pulling too hard on your tape, just place it from edge to edge on your chipboard. Then I will use my nail to push down on this tape. Again, this because I use tape, it's very helpful. So that I really stuck it down in that little opening there. And then again, without pulling on my tape, place it on the bottom of my spine. And again, using my finger to really push it in there. And place it again on the bottom of the chipboard. And I will burnish that in a second when I've finished the whole perimeter of the chipboard. So I will do the same thing on the top of the chipboard. Well, it's now lying on my bottom, but. And I do it so you don't pull on your tape when you are burnishing on your cardstock, when you're placing that on top and burnishing on those little hinges. Well, it's not really a hinge. It's, I don't know what to call the spacing between your chipboard. And then we will place it on the shorter side as well. I'm trying to stay in frame for you guys, but I don't have a really big space to work on, so sometimes it's a bit hard for me. So I've got the tape all over the perimeter on my chipboard now, and I will give that a burnish. Again, also make sure that I place it in there. And it's really important that you don't pull on your tape when you're placing it. Just give it room. And then, I know I use a lot of different sizes of tape on this, and you don't have to, you don't really need all those different sizes of tape. Just use whatever you have. But now I will place the tape around the perimeter of the cardstock, and I will use 3/8 inch for that. And I never go from corner to corner because we are going to cut away quite a piece. So I start just around, let's say 3/4 away from the corner, I will start and stop placing my tape. Because you know, wherever you can save tape, save tape. It's not cheap. Again, trying. Oh, my roll of tape just fell down. Trying to stay in camera for you. Don't pull on it too hard again. No, stop. And the last side. Okay, and then we are going to give that a good burnish as well, so we don't forget. So the next step that we are going to take is to cut away our corners. And you can use different tools to decide what you are going to cut away, but important is that you are going to cut in about a 45 degree angle, and you are staying away about 1/8 inch away from the corner here on your chipboard. So I have this tool here. I don't know what the name for it is in English. It's like a geometric ruler, something like that. And I just, it's helpful for me to make that 45 degree angle. And I see that I'm too close to my chipboard now, so I'm just going to erase that one and we'll do it again. Because your corner will show if you got it away too close to your chipboard. So let's try that again, and that's better. And I will do that on all four corners. And Matt, was it my strongest point in school, as you will be able to see right now? Because I'm struggling on how to use this thing. But there are some pretty handy dandy tools on the market for doing this step. So that's that. And then we will be cutting away those corners. And I'll just use my scissors for this. That's one. And I place my tape before I cut away the corners, because you want to have that tape all the way up to your edge. And you see, even though I didn't place the tape all the way till the end, I'm still cutting away quite a bit. So this is what we have right now. Now we are going to bend our cardstock, give it a bit of a score line, and then I'm starting to bend it. And as you notice, I didn't remove any tape backing yet. So I just pre-folded that edge. And for some reason, I always like to start on the longer side. And I will be removing my tape backing off the longer side on the cardstock and on the chipboard. And I will also remove the tape backing on the chipboard of the shorter side, because your cardstock will go over that. So, and then my next step is more glue, some wet glue. I have the Art Glitter Glue over here, and you don't have to use a lot. Just a little bit is enough. Yes. Just a little stripe is enough. And that will help the cardstock stick to the top of your chipboard. So now we are going to place the cardstock onto the chipboard. And just work it. Don't try to pull on it too hard, just make sure you fold it. How harder you pull on this side, the more chances you have that your album will will pull on itself, and it won't be straight. You can use your fingers or a bone folder for this, both will work. So that's the first side. And we will be doing the same thing on the other side. Then we are going to tuck in our little corners over here. You see how the paper just goes across the chipboard? We have to tuck it in so you get a nice straight edge on your corner. And I like to use my bone folder for this. And this is something that sometimes it will work perfectly and sometimes it just didn't. You just need to do it a lot of times to get better at it. And we'll see how it turns out this time. So again, I will place some wet glue on that edge You see, I don't use a lot, it's just a little bit. And then again, using my bone folder, I will fold it over. Just like that. And then because we fold those edges in, we have a nice straight corner. So we'll be doing the same thing on the other side. Fold in those overlapping pieces. Remove the tape backing. Place some wet glue. And make the fold. Just like that. And that's it, it's wrapped. So now I like to use my bone folder also on this side, just to make sure that it sticks really good to that chipboard. And then I will use my other bone folder. We are going to make sure that the cardstock will bend into that opening here. And I place my finger underneath the left side, so it's lifted a little bit from my workspace. Not too much, just a little bit, and I just work that opening. Push that cardstock down into that opening, and now because I have tape here, it will stick on it. And then when I've done that, I slowly take up the cover a little bit further and further until I feel like I'm able to bend it all the way over. And then I will do the same thing on the other side, just placing my finger underneath there. Give that a good burnish. And then slowly lift it up a little bit further. And I think I can bend it all the way. So that's the cover of our album. Looks pretty neat. So in the next video, I will be showing you how we will be making the binding for this album. So keep your eyes open for that one. Thank you for watching. Enjoy the rest of your day and hopefully see you next time.